Maybe see me now. La 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 la. Hello, hello, Lily family. Hi guys, so welcome back to my channel. It's your girl as always, Lillian Adane. But I noticed that Cameroon people want to bound African music in the country, which is the Cameroon artist them, not like the states, not like the is a law that wants to be imposed now. But the Cameroon artists want to ban, they want to ban Nigerian song in their country. But I don't know why we African like fighting ourselves. Like, I don't get it. You people like embarrassing yourselves online. Like, I don't know, embarrassing yourselves. What is banning Nigerian music in your country? Banning Nigerian music in Cameroon? As in, I don't get. I could remember during those days when I was still a little baby. It's not like when I grew up knowing Makossa as a dance in Nigeria. Because who owns Makossa? Makossa Awilo is from Cameroon. So if your people are not playing your song as it is like now, then you should think of something. What am I doing that is making them not to play my song? What is Nigerian people doing that is extraordinary, that is making our people to like their song more than ours? And because according to the reporter, one of the artists say every bar, everywhere you go, you must, it's all the bars are playing Nigerian song. They said that one of the artists had to go and meet one of the DJs, and I'm like, please, can you please post Nigerian song and be playing Cameroon song? So what they said, like, it's not like we are stopping, or it's not like we are banning African music in Cameroon, but we want Nigerian music to be played at a particular time. But it cannot happen. As that it is, during those days, we use Makossa to do any brand advertisements, Indomie advertisement on the street. I'm not gonna lie to you, I dance Makossa. I used to win something when I was small. I win a lot with it. Indomie, that was when Indomie came out, and I win a lot with it. So why would Cameroon people be saying ban African music? I could know that most of the music that started selling, I grew up to know some of this music as a Cameroon music. So why would they say ban African music? In as much that Nigerian musicians have grown enough, like, to know what is selling for them and know how to rebrand their product and know what people want and give people what they want, then Cameroon's artists too should do the same thing, just like what Nigerians did, Nigerian musicians are doing. So a notice got to them that a product in Cameroon is about to do a program, and they are inviting Naira Marley to the program. And then they are inviting another Cameroon artist to the program, and they are giving that guy little compared to what they are paying the guy $25,000, and they are paying Naira Marley $100K. So, and this product, according to them, that the product is Cameroon product, and they are inviting a foreigner to come and perform. See, guys, it is what it is. That is just all I can tell you guys. And banning Nigerian music in your country won't solve your problem, because after you ban Nigerian music, Ghana might come and take up, and your country might be liking Ghana music. So what do you want? When is Africa going to stop fighting themselves? That is what I'm actually saying. When is Africa going to stop fighting themselves? If you feel like, and even Naira Marley dropped a comment on the on his Instagram, like yes, he's going to come and he's going to teach Cameroon how to love themselves, and you know, now he's going to do a collabo with them and so on and so forth. In as much as we do collabo with you, someone cannot keep on, Nigerian musicians cannot keep on collaborating with Cameroon musicians, because if you no go blue, you no go blue. She get what I mean? And you know, now even though they ban music, they ban Nigerian music in Cameroon, or they banned them from playing Nigerian music in some bars, there's YouTube for people to download it and have you put your earpiece and listen to it at your cool place. There is Google to get any music you want. And you know, people can't just be seeing all those sweet music online. Nigeria have a lot of dancing steps. Nigeria have a lot of music that is danceable. Nigeria have a lot of enjoyable music. So you can't just see people playing. You want to dance, you want to listen to it. See, there's a difference between music and music. Yeah, if you don't know, you should know. There's a difference between music and music. So I don't know, maybe Nigerian artists are giving them music and you guys are giving them music. So I don't know, Cameroon should think of what they're doing, and to shop, if you see that this people is doing something that I'm not doing. If you want to be like somebody, I think you should learn the person very well, study the person, and then try to be more than that person. And then if you see that this person is doing the same thing that I'm doing and it's not working for me, then look for what the person is doing that you're not doing. So I don't know if what I'm saying is making sense. So buying Nigerian music in Cameroon can never solve the problem. That is what I'm saying. Can never solve the problem, because you guys too, Omo, Cameroon don't sell very well for Nigeria. In as much that Nigeria decided to pick up again. Now, then new people died, then try a way to pick up again, because Nigeria died before and they raise up again. So you guys should try and touch up your, because we here in Nigeria, we love our song. In the sense that, if we never play our song, they never enter. Baby, see me now, la 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 la. So yeah. So I think if you Cameroon artists, any of you are watching me now, and then you just trying to, you should just go and study one of the artists. Study Neramadi. Study what he's doing that you're not doing. Study any of the artists. See what is Nigeria artists doing that they're not doing. Because if you go, even in South Africa, you'll be listening to Nigeria song. Ghana, Nigeria song. Cameroon. See, almost all the Africans, it's not only African, the whole world. Nigeria song have taken over the world. So, it's global. So, you can't just stop it. If you stop it, your markets go reduce as a bad person. See, the reason why people play this song in Eba because they want to sell market. And this song is selling my market. And then you're telling me not to play it again. I will not stop playing it, because if I stop playing it, the other shop might be playing it inside their bar or outside their bar, and then me, I'm stop playing it. People want to go and listen. See, there's song that cools your head. I think Nigeria song cooled their heads. That's what I feel like. So we Nigerians, we Africans should stop hating ourselves. Yeah, we should stop hating ourselves and try to love ourselves back. Try to love ourselves and do what we are doing. If you feel like your music is going down and Nigerian music is the one selling, you can collaborate with Nigeria. Collaborate if it takes paying money. Collaborate, and then they'll be like, wow, you know, now collaborate with that selling with the person that your song is selling in your country. So collaborate with the person, and then you see your song will start coming up again. So that is what I feel like. If what I'm saying makes sense, and if you're watching, you've not subscribed to this channel, Akruz, please subscribe to my channel, and then I know you definitely not regret it. I know you will not regret it. So please give this video a big thumbs up, and then I'll see you guys on my next video. Bye.